Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is TWiT.
Bandwidth for TWiT specials is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
This is TWiT Live Special number 268, recorded January 7th, 2016, CES Day 2. This TWiT Live Special is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is the simplest way to create a beautiful landing page for your website, portfolio, blog, business, or online store. Enter offer code TWIT and get 10% off. Squarespace, build it beautiful. The parties are over. The press releases are cold. It's time for us to get dirty here at CES Day 2. This is your dream for the ideal city vehicle. Tell me about the Gen Z.
Yeah, absolutely. So this is the Gen Z 2.0. Gen Z stands for Generation Zero Emissions. And so we wanted to create a vehicle which gets from point A to point B in mega cities. You know, you got crowded cities, people are looking for shared transportation. People do not want to be facing the hassles of a mega city where parking is a problem, traffic is a problem. So something like this where you're not carrying three empty seats with you. You want to get from point A to point B. You've got a vehicle where you can drive and you can carry your stuff with you. This vehicle is the first in the world. It's the first connected electric scooter, right? It's built on a scooter form factor, but it is much more than a scooter. As I said, it allows you to drive as well as carry your stuff. This is a connected vehicle. So if I may just turn this on here, there are no keys on this vehicle. The entire vehicle gets turned on with a PIN code, just like your phone. This vehicle is built on an aluminum frame. The entire vehicle is aluminum. There's not plastic hiding any of the metal that you typically see in a vehicle. The battery is underneath the seat. It's a removable battery. It comes out like a briefcase. You carry it wherever you go into your office. You charge it at your home, and you plug it into any standard 110 or 220 outlet, whichever country you're in. So this way, you can power. Charge it overnight at your home, in your office. You can get juice at Starbucks, wherever you want to get a cup of coffee. So it's a perfect vehicle for this day and age. It's also connected. Every element of this vehicle you can get on your smartphone. We are offering a retail price here of $3,000 today. It's $2,999 to be exact. We are today in the Bay Area and Portland. But from now until April, we're going to start going into Southern California. And then post-April, we're going to get into the rest of the country. So you're going to see us in Florida and Texas and Arizona. You can certainly buy some today. People are buying this all over the country already today. Our only limitation is we don't have service locations as yet set up, and we're in the process of doing that. But today in the Bay Area and in Portland, we're all set up and ready to go.
Fantastic. And if they want to find out more information about your company or your products, where can they go?
Well, the place to go is www.genz.com or just call our number 1-855-GO-GENZ. We're America's first connected electric mobility.
E-Ready is Midland's, prepper branch.
Actually, Midland has been into the emergency prep market for many, many years with Weather Alert Radio. And what we're doing with this is we're promoting a full line of emergency prep products we call E-Ready. E-Ready Emergency Solutions by Midland. We got into this business knowing that the consumer needs to be ready whenever the power goes out. Whether it's a natural disaster, weather-related disaster, or any other kind of a problem, usually the lights are the first to go out. Power goes down. There's also things that we've noticed on the FEMA checklist on their website, ready.gov. And we actually already make some of those products that are on the list. So it's almost like that checklist was made for us. So we put the checklist on all of our packaging and merchandising so that we can help the consumer understand what do they need to put in their go bag or their go kit. Typically, people will like to have a hand crank battery powered type radio so that if the batteries are a little low, they can crank the power. We have two products like that. Other products that you definitely need to have is a signal light. For disaster situations, being able to signal when you can't get your audible voice out there is really important. So whether you have a light or even a whistle, we actually include those items in integrated with some of our products or as an accessory to other products. And then the last thing you definitely need is communication. Yes, you need to have your cell phone ready, but a lot of times in disaster situations, the cell towers are the first to go down. We make two-way radios. It's the most reliable communication, and we also put together a whole kit that has two-way radios, emergency whistle, and a flashlight with the strobe. So you're all set. On the checklist, they'll say, make sure you have an extra set of batteries or a portable battery charger. So this product here has the ability to charge a cell phone over four times. It'll charge a tablet all the way full. And so you can use it for other items than just putting in your go bag. But it's a significant amount of power, has two USB outputs, and it has the flashlight with the signal strobe. And I'm going to show you a really neat feature about this product. It has a light, and a lot of people have flashlights, but this is more like an area light. I'm struggling with this. It's more like an area light, so you don't have to hold it, and the whole entire family can benefit by the light overall. It's adjustable so that you can poke it up to show more areas, or you can poke it down to maybe show a map or some other things. But you also need to have that strobe feature. So you'll have the signal strobe as well as an option. There's a high, low, and signal strobe. A lot of people are going to be away from home and get caught in a situation, and that's what this product is all about. This is a portable weather alert radio. It has the ability, no matter where you are in the United States and Canada, to get weather information, forecast information, or weather alerts, bad things that are happening that the National Weather Service or Industry Canada will put out alerts for. And this one also has the ability to, it's called same technology, and it's the ability to program out what you don't want and program in only the alerts you do want. You can basically program your own county, and that's it, not get the other county's alerts. And that's a really significant achievement for such a small radio. Yeah, this is almost like the kit within a kit. You have two two-way radios, GMRS, will talk to any walkie-talkie out there. You have a nice addition into here of having a weather alert radio built into your walkie-talkie, so you can actually get weather forecasts and alerts right on the walkie-talkie. This one has a 2,000 milliamp hour battery, lithium-ion battery. It'll hold a charge for 3 or 4 months, so you can use it as a battery backup or recharge your cell phone. But what you're probably really going to use it for is to run the weather alert radio. So it'll run for 25 consecutive hours off of one charge. If you do need to charge it up at all, and this is really, I think it's better for if you have to, you're out of batteries and you have to get an emergency phone call off, you can crank this thing for a couple minutes and get enough power to get a phone call off. You don't have to sit there and do this all day. So that's really helpful too. We also include a small solar charger, and that what that does is help maintain the battery charge when it's out in the sunlight. This has a 2600 milliamp battery. It'll operate for 32 hours on the radio, keep the radio playing for 32 hours. It also has a really unique dog whistle in there. Dogs that are trained for search and rescue, you press the button and they hear this audible tone that they can hear you can't hear, and they're drawn to it. So that's a really neat feature for this one. It does have a little bit bigger solar panel to help maintain the battery a little bit more, and it has the ability to have a weather alert go off for your area. So it's all kind of a built-in, one for everything kind of a situation here.
All right, Terry, if they wanted to find out more about the E-Ready line, where can they go online?
They should go to MidlandUSA.com.
I guess the big question here is pricing and availability.
Availability will be in retail probably by February. And pricing on all of the products are MSRP about $49.99, with the bigger hand crank radio being $69.99.
Why fixed wing? I mean, all the buzz has been about multi-rotor craft, and now you've given us a more traditional flight.
Yeah, so this is the latest run from Parrot, the Parrot Disco, and we want you to have a new user experience compared to the traditional bebop and the traditional quadcopter. Here, for example, when you fly with this kind of product, you will have a very immersive way to pilot. You can use FPV glasses with the front camera that's in the front of the product, and it's possible to use FPV glasses So you can have the video streaming in front of your eyes. When the wing rolls, you will have the video that rolls also, and you will be in the air, and you will travel in the sky by yourself. It will be very amazing, good experience.
Why would I want a fixed wing? What does a fixed wing give me that I can't get off of my quadcopter?
So with a quadcopter, you have the feeling that you are suspended in the air. Here you will slide in the air. You will make some curves in the air, and it will be very amazing. It will be very different. This is a fixed wing drone that is very easy to use also. There are three main parts, two wings, one body. You can just plug the two wings on the body, and you are ready to fly. This is very important. It's very easy. So you take the product in the hand, you shake it, the motor starts to spin, and you are ready to take the takeoff. So you throw it in the air, and it will climb automatically to 50 meters altitude, making some circles in the sky. So now you can use the remote sky controller Wi-Fi product that allows you to pilot very easily the drone. It's not like a plane. You don't have to handle the mixing of the roll and the pitch. Here, if you want to turn on the left, you just pull the or move the stick on the left. There is an autopilot that will automatically manage to keep the same altitude. So there is no risk for the user and no need to touch the ground. So also there is assisted landing mode. You can press the button. It can go to the ground in a circular way. So it will move down in a spiral and touch the ground. Or you can just press the button also and it could go to the ground in a linear way. So it's very easy, and the user, everybody can use this kind of product. There is no learning, so it's very easy. It will be on the market by the end of the year, this year.
Now, if they wanted to find out more about Parrot, about the Disco, about any of the drones that you offer, where can they go?
You can go on parrot.com website.
Now, Andrea, when a lot of my audience think about routers, they think it's that boring box next to my cable modem. What could possibly be exciting? Why should they care about this new box from Synology?
You know, Synology has designed this router. It's really a dynamic and exciting router, specifically because it's easy to control. And it gives you, the home user, even more control over your network. So, for example, we have excellent parental controls on our router that will allow you to go in and, using an application layer QoS, that will allow you to specifically come in, and we can show you this, control, one, your traffic, so that you can, if you have a lot of devices on your network, that you can determine which one of your devices is the one that you want to prioritize for getting traffic, and which ones that you want to have customizable speed for. I mean, it's really great. Now, you're like, why would I want this at my home? Let's say, for example, you're a person who ends up consulting from your house, and you're using one laptop specifically to do a lot of, doing a lot of consulting work, where maybe you work with high resolution images, or you're working with very large files, then you can prioritize that device over others on your network. But also, and this is one of the things that's really amazing about the Synology router, the Synology router has private cloud capability. And so it has an SD port on the side, and then it also has a USB 3 port, so that you can use your router as your own private cloud and DNLA media server, and it's only $149.99. And so that's one of the things that people really love, the price point, and also that you get so much more functionality out of a Synology router. In terms of parental controls, it gives you even more control over your network. So, for example, you can schedule, you can add a device, and schedule it by device. So, for example, if you want your kids doing their homework right after school and you don't want them surfing the web, what you can do is you can actually set up a block, and it's so easy with Synology, so that you block out the time so that they can't go surfing the web. Instead, they will not have access, and they can just do their homework. Another huge cool feature in this particular router is that we also have a web filter. Now, this is really going to come in handy for people who have kids, people who maybe are sharing a network with others, and they want to control the content that those people are getting on their network. So what we've done is we're using a DNS web-based filter, and we've comprised group categories of sites, and we've already comprised these for you. We are maintaining these for adult content, for drugs, for hacking, for advertising, for malware, dating. And we allow you, the user, to go in and select what is a higher priority, what would you like to have blocked on your system. And it's a huge time saver because you don't have to go in and add each site individually. You can just go ahead and use our group level blocking. And you can also customize this. So if you want to, for example, add a site that you think, okay, well, maybe that one is fine, you can go back in and you can edit it. And you can do this by device. So that's one of the features that people really like. I mean, so if you, and it's, in summary, I would say, you know, having the private cloud capability, having a DNLA media server, having application layer QoS, having these web-based DNS filters so that you can do group level blocking. I mean, all of that for $149.99, I mean, it's quite, we're quite proud of it.
If the folks at home want to find out more about this new router or any of the products that Synology offers, where can they go?
Synology.com.
Travis, this is a beautiful piece of kit. Tell me a little bit about this blade.
Sure. So this is truly the ultimate ultrabook. It's incredibly thin and lightweight. It weighs only 2.75 pounds and is also 0.52 inches thin. So it's very easy to carry around with you. It has an absolutely stunning, gorgeous display. It's a 4K resolution panel, and it also supports 10-point touch, so you can interact with Windows 10 in all new ways. Each key supports up to 16.8 million color options, so you can cycle through a number of different effects, or it also has Chroma SDK integration that game developers are taking advantage of, so the keyboard can actually interact with some of the popular new games like Call of Duty.
What's the starting price on this blade?
Great question. We're really excited about this. It's starting at only $9.99, and that's with an Intel Core i7 processor. So the notebook itself has Thunderbolt 3. Via that Thunderbolt 3 connection port, you can hook it up to the new Razer Core, which is an external desktop graphics amplifier. Now, the Razer Core allows you to install your own preferred graphics card from either AMD or NVIDIA, and it supports full-size dual-wide GPUs. In the example here, we have a GTX 980 Ti. The power supply inside is a 500-watt power supply, so you have plenty of room to power all your GPUs. Now, that Thunderbolt cable will not only transfer data at up to 40 gigs per second, but it also charges the notebook via the single cable.
Travis, thank you very much for speaking with us. If they want to find out more about the blade, more about your expansion chassis, if they want to find out about anything Razer may offer, where can they go?
RazerZone.com or swing by the booth at CES.
Mark, what is Yale doing with smart locks?
Well, actually, we're doing a lot with smart locks. Yale's been around for about 170 years, so we really know how to make locks. But in the last 5 years, we really worked on creating smart locks within both ecosystems and also standalone. What we're showing here at the show within the, in the Z-Wave Alliance booth is our smart lock here, the Yale Real Living Lock. This is our push-button version. And with that, you have a 4- to 8-digit code you can enter. When you enter that, you unlock your door. Now, when you tie that into the Z-Wave ecosystem, not only did I unlock the door, but I turned off the security system. I may have turned on lights that I have selected in the home. I could have changed my thermostat temperature to, now that I'm home, I want the temperature to come up. And maybe it's my kids coming home, and maybe mom got a text saying the kids are home. So, you know, a lot of information. Not only is it security, because, again, we've been around for a long time, we know how to make locks, but really it's about convenience and information. Then, going from this push-button version, we then also offer another version here, our touch screen. So we have a dark screen. I touch that. I wake up my lock. I put my 4-digit code in. And, again, the same scenario, but now we have a touch screen. It's unlocked on the way out. I can maybe just touch it, and I can lock the lock.
Mark, if they want to find out more about Yale or more about what it means to be part of the Z-Wave Alliance, where can they go?
YaleRealLiving.com, and there you'll find all the information on our electronic locks as well as our mechanical locks. We also have Yale2U.com as well.
I'm speaking with Alexi, who's going to explain what Beyond Home can do for you. Alexi, this looks just like a light bulb, but you say it's smart. Why is that?
Yeah, that's exactly what we want. We think that smart home automation should literally be as simple as screwing in a light bulb. And what we tried to do was capture that entire experience in essence, in just screwing in a light bulb. So what this is a simple LED bulb, and there's two parts to it. There's the LED bulb, and then there's what's called the smart module. The smart module inserts in the bulb, and the light turns on because there's a battery inside. The battery is there so that it'll work during a power outage. And so that it doesn't, whether the switch is in the on or the off position, it still works. You don't need to worry about anything. So you screw the bulbs in, it starts learning your lighting patterns, and it plays it back while you're out of the house to make it look like you're still there. If a burglar rings the doorbell, which they always do, the light will turn on sequentially in the bedroom, in the hallway, in the entranceway, makes it look like someone is waking up and moving throughout the house. If you have a fire alarm or a smoke alarm, all the lights turn on to help you get out of the house faster. And one of the really cool things about this is because it's modular, we can add new features that do different things. So it's actually a platform in your light bulbs to basically customize your home a la carte with smart home automation, all while keeping the same thing as simple as screwing in a light bulb. So let me show you one of the really cool things that it does. So after it learns your lighting patterns, kind of like a DVR for your lighting, you can actually take a look before you go on vacation. You can take a look at what your home will look like while you're away. So what this is your coming up on your schedule of what your recorded schedule was for the previous week. And these green areas are the actual lighting patterns. So you can slow it down. You can actually stand outside of your house and see what all the different rooms lighting up and kind of give you that confidence that, hey, this is what my home's going to be doing while I'm gone.
Alexei, thank you very much for speaking with us. Now, if they wanted to find out more about your line, about your products, about what you're doing in the Z-Wave Alliance, where can they go?
Just go to beyondhome.com. We've got all kinds of great information on there that explains the product in more detail. That's where you can buy the product, and it's also available on Amazon.
Thank you very much for speaking with us. Let's start with the MoFi. The MoFi was introduced last year. What makes it special?
So MoFi was our first headphone introduced last year, and as you can see, it is a completely different design from a headphone. We designed our headphone line from the ground up. We said if we didn't know what a headphone looked like, what would we design? So we have a four-bar linkage system that keeps the ear cups parallel at all times. It also is great for head shapes and sizes as well as comfort. We also have a pivoting hinge to allow for easy adjustability without that cranking down kind of ratchet sound, as well as being able to extend fully while it's around your neck to lay comfortably on your chest. It also keeps the ear cup, which is shaped like an ear, connected at the center. Great for accurate pressure, kind of even pressure around, keeping the cabinet, acoustical cabinet, from angling one way or the other. And just creating a much better, more comfortable fit. What's also great about MoFi is obviously the sound quality. So we have massive custom 50mm drivers in here that give you full range, incredible clarity, incredible detail. And then with MoFi, we also built in an amplifier. So that way you kind of have a hi-fi system inside the headphones if you have high-res files or lossless audio or you want to get that more, you're used to carrying around an amplifier, we've now built it into the headphone. So MoFi came out last year. It's a big hit. People were big fans. And then this year we've introduced Lola. Lola is MoFi's little sister. And Lola keeps that same design to keep your ear cups parallel at all times. Same hinge design, same acoustic cabinet design, and also the same 50mm drivers inside. But Lola's for those people who don't need the power of an amplifier. So if you like a passive headphone, you have your own amplifier. That's just not kind of your style, but you still have those drivers, same as in MoFi, to get detail, to your detail in your music that other headphones on the market just don't deliver.
Now, here's the big question. Price points and availability. If they want to look at these two headphones, figure out which one is for them, where can they go?
Absolutely. So you can try these out and see these in Best Buy, Magnolia, home theater stores. So go in, feel free to try them out. They're available there on Best Buy Online, Amazon, Guitar Center. You can find these at a lot of places on the web. Lola being newer, you can find that at Guitar Center, Amazon. It's coming soon to Best Buy Online and several stores coming January, February, and March. You'll start to see Lola more and more at your favorite retailer. Price point wise, you do have $349 price point for MoFi with a built-in amp and $249 for Lola.
Let's take a moment to thank the sponsor of this TWiT special, and it's Squarespace. Now, if you think about all the businesses that are here at CES, they all have one thing in common, no matter what they might be building, selling, or trying to make you buy, and that is they need a web presence. If you don't exist on the web, well, I'm sorry, you just don't exist. Now, you could go the old-fashioned route. You could learn HTML, maybe some responsive CSS. Perhaps you're going to make your own agreements with an ISP to serve out, you know, exactly the page that you want. Yeah, you could do all that and then worry about updating and worry about maintaining and worry about making sure it's up all the time. or you could just go with Squarespace. Now, Squarespace will give you a easy to build, easy to use, beautiful, responsive web page. What I love about Squarespace is that I can make a Squarespace page for the organizations that I deal with that are maybe not so tech savvy, and they can update it on their own time. They can make a portfolio if they want to show off photos from their latest event. They could create a page for a fundraiser. They can even accept online payments. Squarespace makes it easy. Not only that, they make it responsive. If you've ever tried to view a web page on a mobile device that's not built for a mobile device, well, you know why you need responsiveness. You want it to be reformatted for every person who visits your page, and Squarespace does it automatically. Now, we're going to make it easy for you to try a Squarespace page today. Just go to squarespace.com and use the offer code TWIT, and you'll get 10% off. That's right, 10% off just by going to squarespace.com and using the offer code TWIT. Squarespace, build it beautiful. And we thank Squarespace for their support of this TWIT Live special. If you're the proud owner of one of the new MacBooks, then you know about the pain of USB-C. Yes, it's wonderful to have your peripherals and your power come into the same port, but there's one problem, and that problem is here. If there's only one port, how do you split it? Unless you buy one of Apple's really expensive peripherals, you're not going to be able to power and connect at the same time. That is, unless you're here at Energy. I'm here with Julian, who's going to explain what Energy is doing for those people who need to expand their USB-C horizons. Julian,
hi.
What is this?
This is the USB-C adapter that comes with all the USB-A, HDMI, or VGA port, as well as the USB-C, which supports the USB-PD, which stands for the power distribution. Okay, so it hooks up with all the devices that you need, including all the HDMI-enabled devices, projectors, TV, and everything, with that only one port available as newest MacBook Air or MacBook.
Now, this is very exciting for the people who live in Macworld, because we all know that you have to buy your charger from Apple. You can only buy your charger from Apple. In fact, if you ever try to buy a connector from a manufacturer with one of those MagSafe, they got sued. That's just how it works. But with USB-C, the promise is to standardize that. So you've given us this. This gives us 45 watts out of this charger that we can then plug into this hub and plug the hub into the MacBook. Now, the wonderful thing about this is not only do you get all the advantages of USB-C, and that means that you can get power and connectivity. Also, it means that there is no right side. You can flip it either way. But because you've got multiple breakouts, I can have pass-through power that gives power to the laptop, to any peripherals I have connected. Plus, you've given me the option of also having HDMI or VGA out. Tell me, when you designed this, how did you decide that this was going to be the format and this is what you were going to include in the feature set?
The beauty of MacBook, the newest MacBook, is coming handy to allow users to carry things as simple as possible with them. But once in a while, for emergency use, that users still bump into the newer or existing devices like HDMI connection and everything. So we come up with such USB-C adapter, which come with the most popular I/O interface available in the market. For example, you just mentioned HDMI or VGA, and then the most popular USB-A connector, as well as the needed USB-PD power port.
All right, now, brass tacks. Availability and price, because I know all the Mac fans out there, they want this. They're going to want it because they want an extra charger that's not from Apple, that's not going to have all the Apple premium. Yes. They're going to want the hub. When can they get this, and how much is it going to cost?
Okay. This particular hub will be available in just a few weeks, and then the price will be at $59.99, and it will have three colors available that will be matching with your newest MacBook: color, space gray, and then silver.
And Julian, if they want to go and find out more about the entire line of products from Energy, where can they go online?
Please come to visit us at myenergy.com.
Every year at CES, I make a pilgrimage here to Audio Technica. And what a year it is, because they released these. The best sounding headphones I've ever put on my ears. These are the MSR7s. You've seen them on Know How, on Before You Buy, and on This Week in Enterprise Tech on our network. And I got to say, they are the most comfortable, best sounding headphones I've ever seen for under $400. Well, Audio Technica's not relaxed enough to sit on their laurels, even though this won best headphone of the year. I'm here with Crystal, who's going to explain how they upped their MSR7 game. Crystal, this was nice, That's better. Tell me about those MSR7 noise-canceling headphones.
Yeah, so this is the next version, the next step up. So we're expanding our line of high-resolution headphones. And if you're not familiar with the high-res conversation, you know, a lot of phones are kind of getting more memory these days. And now lossless music files can now be held on your phone. So what's nice about that is that you need some good headphones to be able to listen to those high-resolution files now. And that's what we've got provided here. But this takes it a little step further. Our MSR7 coupled with noise canceling technology. So you get all of the great features that you get from the MSR7 plus the great sound, and now you have the additive feature of the noise cancellation so that you can block everything out and really just concentrate on your audio.
Now, I know the MSR7s, as we reviewed them, were about $249. What does the noise canceling at?
These are $299.
All right, so let's go from MSR7. These are nice, but let's say someone wants a smaller headset, something that will travel a little easier, maybe something a little less expensive. What do you have in that?
Yeah, so again, like we said, we kind of took that a step further and expanded our our high-resolution line and came out with the SR5. So what you have here is a corded version. This is kind of, but you can see it's a little bit smaller. So this is an on-ear form factor for people who might want something a little bit more lightweight, a little bit less conspicuous, and just kind of a little bit nicer in a smaller package. And that's what we've got here with the SR5. So this is a corded version. Again, high-resolution headphones, has all of the great qualities that the MSR7 has.
All right, let's move away from headphones because I'm feeling the need for some fusion, maybe something old school with a little bit of new technology. What do you have for that?
I can't believe that you're asking this because I have the perfect product for you. This is our new Bluetooth turntable. So, yeah, like you said, you know, taking a modern day twist on something that's kind of old school. You know, turntables, we have seen an explosion in sales lately. You know, vinyl is making a huge comeback, and it's really the millennial crowd that's driving it. You know, it's a younger crowd that wants more of an experience with their music, and that's the physical, like, thing that you get from vinyl. And so, you know, turntables is the next step, obviously, that you need to grow, and that's going to grow with the vinyl sales. So what we've done here is we've basically integrated Bluetooth technology so you can stream your vinyl to a Bluetooth speaker or a Bluetooth headphone. Right here we have headphones hooked up. But the cool thing about this is, you know, if you think about it, who's got entertainment centers anymore? You know, entertainment centers are a thing of the past with flat screens and things getting smaller, and nobody needs that in their living room anymore. So you can keep this in your with your vinyl, maybe it's in a spare bedroom or something like that, and you can listen to the vinyl wherever you want to. So we're actually making something analog portable now. So it's just a different way of looking at the industry and saying, hey, young people, we've got a solution for you, you know, that I think everybody is going to latch on to and really think that this is great. And for a price of $179.95, I mean, this is a really great product for that price.
Headphones, turntables, I'm glad we stopped by Audio Technica. Hopefully it won't be another year till I see you, but if they want to find out more about your product line, not just these headphones and turntables, but everything, from your mics to all of your other audio equipment, where can they go?
All of our products can be found on audiotechnica.com.
VR technology has no doubt advanced in the last decade or so, but here at Virtuix, they want to take it one step further. I'd say even going holodeck style. I'm here with Lorenzo, who's going to explain what this contraption behind us can do for your virtual experience. Lorenzo, what is this?
Yes, so today at CES, we're showing off the Omni. The Omni is a motion platform that allows players to walk in 360-degree environments, whether you want to walk or run inside virtual worlds.
And I like this. So it's a harness that can swivel 360 degrees, so you can turn in any direction. And then you've got special shoes that will slip on the surface so that you can actually walk, you can run. Are there sensors in the floor to tell the Omni where you are?
There's actually no sensors or moving parts, but we do have the IMU tracker pods on top of each shoe. This allows the player to run analog speed within the game. Our concave base is a low-friction material, which conceals with our low-friction shoes as you would run on a traditional treadmill.
What I like about this approach is there are some very good VR products. I'm not going to knock anyone out there, but you don't actually move. I mean, if you move, you have a controller that moves you. To get your body involved like this, I think it really does add to not just gaming, but to any experience you might do in VR.
I agree, and that's what we're promoting here is what we call active VR. This is what we call to help increase immersion when experiencing virtual reality. Okay, so right now, our player, he's got a gun, he's walking through a virtual space, and to move, he's actually got to walk, so you can't just push a control button. Let me ask you, I mean, what applications do you see for this beyond, say, this stock game?
We've had very, very much interest from other applications such as physical therapy, virtual tourism, architectural design. We really believe that if you really want to be immersive inside of virtual reality, this is the only way to do it.
All right, Lorenzo, our audience has a lot of geeks, and actually he's shooting me right now, which is awesome. They're going to want to know pricing and availability.
Price is $699 for pre-order on our website, Vertrix.com.
And if they do want to find out more, of course, they should try to get you here at CES. But where are you located in case they do want to see one of these in person?
We are based out of Austin, Texas. We are at the monthly, I believe, or bi-monthly VR Austin meetup. So check out for that, and we'll have Omnis available for demo.
With the advent of VR headsets that have true high-definition quality, you need to somehow get the content made. Now, you could patch together a series of cameras and perhaps stitch the image into something that does or does not look right, or you could just come to Gyroptic. I'm speaking with Richard, who's going to explain what the 360 cam can do for you. Richard, what is this?
Well, your life is not moving in a frame, so your regular camera is capturing a frame that is 16 by 9. What we do is we capture a sphere, we capture your environment. So it's made of three fisheye lenses, it's looking in three different directions, and it's actually taking the data, not missing anything. The only blind spot would be where actually standing and where the camera is being set. We stitch the images in real time inside the device. Why do you care about real time? Well, your smartphone is real time, video is real time. You don't want post-processing. You don't want to go to your computer to do stitching and long processing. Three microphones, why? You want surround sound. Surround sounds meaning like HMD, I rotate up, down, all around, and I get different type of sound. Gyroscope inside for one simple reason, that if you rotate the camera, it's still a sphere rotating on itself. You don't want to see anything happening in your headset. So if we do that, we stabilize the image. Wi-Fi, GPS, because Google Street View made pictures geolocalized. So we thought that was definitely necessary. Very simple product, less than 200 grams, $500, available on 360.tv.
Okay, now we got to geek out over the specs. And tell me, why did you go with the three-camera approach? Because there are many different vendors who are doing two cameras on either side with fisheye lenses. There are some vendors who are doing multiple cameras, 20 cameras. What made you decide that three was the number for you?
Well, three made the number because first you get a cute design. That's one thing. The second thing is we use regular lenses, like fisheye lenses. We need to go with molding lenses. We're definitely looking at 2, 4, and so on. 3 was the number, like, in terms of price, quality, and, like, what we wanted to achieve, definitely.
All right, now, for those people who are looking at this product and they're saying, I like this, I want to play with this, tell me what would be the process. So they mount this on their head. Let's say they're wearing a hat with a 360 cam. Once they film it, what can they do with it? How do they process it? How do they push it out?
So, again, no process. One button, you press, it starts recording. Helmet on a pole, wherever, like on the table during Christmas, like Christmas was, it's past, but for next year's Christmas, press the button, it records in 360 degree. What you get out of that is plain MP4 file, JPEG, already stitched, so capturing everything. Take those files, put them on YouTube, put them on Facebook, and you get this 360 degree interactive view. No processing, you don't even need a computer. Straight from this, using your app or your smartphone, you can do it.
Oh, this is the tech that we've been waiting for. Now, Richard, if they want to find out more about the 360 cam, if they want to find out more about Gyroptic, where can they go?
360.tv, that's www.360.tv. Very simple. You go there, you get all the information, you can get in touch with us. There's a gallery with sample contents. Go there and don't hesitate to contact us if you have any question.
VR shows a lot of promise, but for me, there's nothing quite like AR. Augmented reality really opens up the avenues for bringing information into the real world, which is why we're here at ODG looking at the R7s. I'm standing next to Nima, who's going to explain why the R7 is unlike any other AR headset. You may have seen Nima. What makes the R7 so good?
Great question. So in essence, this is a high-end tablet on your head. Anything your phone or tablet can do, this device can do. Built-in processing power, built-in connectivity, built-in IMU. So the device knows where you are, what you're doing, and allows you to interact with the real world. And then magic, Robert, is a dual 720p displays at 80 frames per second that are 80% see-through.
Now, we were playing with this earlier, and what I love about it is it locks on. I mean, when it overlays information, it doesn't do what I've seen with a lot of other AR headsets where you turn your head and the entire world takes a while to catch up. That's because of the internal processing. I mean, you've actually built in beefy processing into this. It's not just doing everything on your phone or your tablet.
Exactly. The three pillars that ODG stood on is a cinema quality optics, full integration. We're talking about Snapdragon 805. It is one of the best processors out there. And then full mobility. This is a product you can wear, use anywhere, move, interact with the real world, and it augments it with the digital world.
Now, where do you see this being useful? I mean, obviously, every geek and consumer out there is going to want a set of AR glasses, but I mean, these are super high-end. So what is your ideal customer?
Great question. So ODG is very systematically refining the product. We first started with government and heavy industry. Now we're announcing the R7 that's targeted to the enterprise before we go after the consumer holy grail. And the use cases are endless. So we have medical use cases, telepresence, logistics, navigation, computational power, like just email and browsing on the glasses. So it, in essence, is a computer. In fact, we won the 2016 CES Mobile Computing and Tablet Division. So that's a big statement from industry.
One of the things that actually impressed me, and I don't normally think price is going to impress, but you decided that rather than giving a half-baked product with kind of the specs that you want, with some of the processing power you need, you went all in and you said, look, it's a high-end device. We're going to charge you as much as we need. What's the price point on the R7?
Great question. So right now it's $2,750 at quantity one. And the reason why it's that price point is, as you said, we're not compromising on anything. You have a high-end 720p resolution display in your pocket or on your head. It is like looking at a big screen TV anywhere in the real world. You have a blazing processor. You have 64 gigs of internal memory, all incorporated in a device that's 5.5 ounces.
All right, now that is, even though I love these glasses and I know people will love them once they try them on, that is a lot of cash just to buy on faith. So would there be a place, other than CES, because of course this would be a great place to try them on, where they might be able to find a set, talk to a representative, find more information about the R7?
Yeah, great point. So the hardware is the barrier to entry. Right? It is the software and the content that makes it magical. So we have a VAR program, value-added retailer. So if you have some amazing technology or have come up with a brilliant idea, contact out at Osterout Group. We'll could get one of these in your hands, on your head, play with it, develop with it. We're also launching our app center, our reticle app center, so your applications can reside on product. Again, it's standard Android. So if you have an Android app, it will work natively on our product.
I guess the last question would be, if they wanted to go online just to find out some quick information about ODG, about what you do, where can they go?
Yeah, osterhoutgroup.com, ODG, just Google us and you'll read a lot of good stuff.
The surprise story out of CES has been this graph behind me. This is the 184 from Ehang. Now, this is a one-person octocopter that will vertically take off and land, take you up to 2 miles away on its 23 minutes of battery charge. Now, the masterminds behind this are Ehang. And believe it or not, they've been doing the drone game for quite a long time, which is why I'm speaking with Liping from Ehang, who's going to explain what Ehang does for this this field. Liping, this is getting all the attention, which I think is a masterstroke, but you do actually make a full line of drones.
We do. Yes, we do. What I'm carrying in my hand is our consumer drone. We call it Ghost Drone 2.0 product. It actually controls with your smartphone, so people don't need to learn how to use a controller. Just download an application on your smartphone. You can just use it. Kids can play with it as well.
I have to say, this field has gotten so crowded so quickly. 5 years ago, nobody had a drone, unless you hacked it together. Last year, we saw an explosion of companies that have bought out drones. Now, with this being a multi-billion dollar business around the world, everyone wants a piece. What makes your drones different? I mean, aside from the fact that you've got a very good app-controlled flight system, why did you design it so that you're using pusher props rather than pull props?
We think it's thanks to the really big evolutionary product improvements of all those sensors because of smartphone. A lot of those sensors are actually, similar. So you can reuse it because of the delivery shipment of smartphone being so popular, so the pricing actually goes down tremendously. That's how the drone industry can grow so fast in the past few years.
All right, now let's get to the brass tacks here. If someone was going to say, look, I've got a choice of literally a dozen different companies within a five-minute walk from here who can provide me a camera platform or a fun weekend flying platform, what would you say to them? What would you tell them to convince them that they want to try your product rather than something from, say, DJI or from Unique?
Everybody's product has their uniqueness, but to our product, and we provide smartphone experience to you. You don't just play with yourself. You play with your girlfriend. You play with your kids. So it can be a family thing to play together. So we really actually putting down the standard of being a flyer much, much lower to majority part of the people.
Let's get geeky. Can you show off some of the features here? So, of course, you see the inverted props. So we're used to seeing puller props. They're using a different mode here, which puts the thrust line closer to the center of gravity. But show me some of the other features, because I see you've got GPS, you've got a gimbal. What will I get if I buy one of your drones?
There's different functions, like 6 meters of them. One of the biggest thing is that with the smartphone control, there's a battery management system. So with the waypoint version, you take off. You just press the button to take off. And there's a button that says land. So it comes back automatically to the spot that you takes off. And also with the avatar mode, the drone actually follows you wherever you go. And the head of the drone will always be facing you. So you don't have a problem figuring out, oh, where my drone should go, left or right.
I think this is actually part of this trend that I've seen at CES, where the field is maturing, and we're moving from just toys to now they're tools. And this is definitely a drone for someone who wants a tool. They want a waypoint, they want some film, they want some footage. This is what they choose. All right, now, if they're convinced that they want to check out your products, where can they go? How much do they cost, and what's the availability?
Sure. Check out, I think, mostly our dealers in America. This product just get launched like 2 months ago worldwide, and we are really penetrating into U.S. market. I believe pretty soon in all those major chain stores, you're going to get one, and also on Amazon as well.
And the all-important price point?
It ranges from the standard and to the flagship motion. We do have a VR goggle, and we have the VR goggle version. You can actually see what you fly, so you really feel like you are a bird flying while the drone flies with you. The price range could be around $400 to $500 at a standard version to a much higher one. Depends on what kind you buy as well.
That brings an end to our coverage of CES Day 2. From a new take on the flying car to an ultrabook for gaming that's under $1,000 to an advancement in home networking, the South Hall has provided us some very interesting looks at the future of technology. Don't forget to join us tomorrow, CES Day 3, here on TWiT TV. Until then, I'm Father Robert Ballecer, the Digital Jesuit, saying goodbye from CES Day 2.